Okay, so far I've showed you how to create these models, how to define them, and how to make sure that they actually exist in the database. So the next thing is you'll actually want to, you know, read and write and query these tables from your code. This could either be in your views, which we'll come to later, or it could be in other parts of the Django application. Now, probably an easy way to demonstrate this is to open up Django's shell. So if you do python manage.py and then do shell, it'll open up a Python REPL, but inside the environment, so inside the Django environment. So we can import this some of these models that we've created. So let's import the destination one and create an example destination. So let's do the import first. So from rallycloud.models import destination. And the way to query the destination table is to do destination, so the object dot objects, and then we can use the all method to get all of the entries. Now, so far there aren't any entries. We don't have anything in the database, so let's create a new one. We can give it a name, so let's call it Mars, and we call the class by calling the constructor, so instantiating it. And then I know that we've got name, we've got description, and we've got slug. So let's set each of those as keyword arguments when we call this constructor. So the name will be Mars. The description will be the red planet. And then the slug can be Mars. Once we've done that, that object only exists inside the shell. It doesn't exist inside the database yet. So if you run the save method on the instance, then it will have then created that information in the database. So if I run that query again to get all objects, you'll see that we get back that destination Mars object. So if we get the first one, we can see the destination, we can then see the name, we can see the description. So when you're working with data in the database inside Django, you're always using the models to interface into the database. You never have to write, only in very special circumstances, but you generally never have to write SQL queries directly. You work with the model's interface to read and write from the database. Okay, so if you do destination.objects.all, that will give you all entries. There are lots of other methods you can run on the objects field. Probably the most common one you're going to be using is the all method. You can also do things like filter, for example. So if you wanted to get all entries where the name maybe meets that criteria, there are a number of other special properties you can do when using filters. Also, you can do and or clauses. There's a whole range of different things you can do with Django queries. And because we set the name to be unique, then we can actually just get the instance if we already know the name of the destination. So if you go for destination.objects.get, and then the keyword argument would be the field, which is name, and then the value would be the one that we're trying to find. So name, it will throw an exception if that it can't find that record or it finds more than one of those. So that's an easy way to get individual objects back. Let's just go one step further and assign that to a variable. And let's change the description of that object. And the way that you update that in the database is you would run again the save method on that entry. So that's how you read and write from the database in Django using Django models.